Thank you all for being here. I think I know everybody, but just in case, I'm Paul Frey, Mayor of the City of Norfolk, and I'm really pleased to have the opportunity to welcome all of you to this discussion tonight. Thank you for being a part of it. I want to acknowledge the presence of my colleague on the City Council, Barclay Nguyen, who is here with us. I think I saw the Commonwealth Attorney, Greg Underwood, here as well. And also want to acknowledge the presence of the City Manager, Marcus Jones, and our great Chief of Police, Mike Goldsmith. And again, thank all of you very much for being here. Norfolk has a centuries-old history of resilience. With early roots in hostilities between the Algonquin-speaking tribes of the Virginia coastal plain and English colonists, Norfolk repeatedly has faced obstacles and trials. A major colonial port, Norfolk was the only American town almost completely destroyed during the Revolutionary War and then rebuilt by the end of the century. In 1855, more than 10% of the population died in the yellow fever epidemic, and the city was held under martial law and burned during the Civil War. Flooded repeatedly during the past century, Norfolk has bounced back, retaining a position as the region's center for business, medical, educational, and cultural activity. You've been invited here tonight, this evening, to celebrate Norfolk's selection to participate in a global network of cities and to kick off our mutual efforts to build a more resilient Norfolk. This effort will require comprehensive engagement from all neighborhoods, institutions, businesses, and nonprofits across the city, and we need your participation to realize this vision. This past December, the Rockefeller Foundation announced the first 33 cities that will receive support through its 100 Resilient Cities Challenge. First announced in May of 2013, the challenge is being held in honor of the Rockefeller Foundation's 100th year anniversary. The goal of the endeavor is to award $100 million to 100 cities around the world to help prepare them to better withstand and recover from major disasters and catastrophes. Norfolk is proud to be among the first 11 cities in the United States and 33 cities globally to be selected for this initiative. The foundation is funding the initiative in response to factors like urbanization and the increase in size and scope of natural and man-made disasters in recent years. This week, we kick off our work to engage stakeholders in the conversation about what resilience means. Subsequent steps will include development of a resilience strategy and the hiring of a chief resilience officer. The foundation will help identify funding and other resources necessary for effective development of this strategy. Norfolk's extreme vulnerability to both natural and man-made extreme events made the city a good candidate for the 100 Resilient City Challenge. For Norfolk, flooding and sea level rise is a defining challenge for the 21st century, and the city is fully engaged in addressing it through a comprehensive approach. Norfolk takes a whole community approach based on hazard mitigation, preparedness, response, and recovery. This is carried out through our disaster preparedness and flooding strategy that is multifaceted and cross-disciplined. Team Norfolk has built critical relationships in all sectors, public, private, not-for-profit, higher education, and military, establishing a true comprehensive community-wide approach to preparedness. The team's goal is a secure and resilient city with the capabilities required to prevent, protect against, mitigate, respond to, and recover from the threats and hazards that pose the greatest risk. Norfolk's evolution in learning to live with water as a coastal city, subject to rising sea levels and recurrent flooding, informs our approach to resilience as a whole. We strive to become better prepared to withstand catastrophic events, both natural and man-made, and to reestablish function and avoid long-term disruptions. While our strategies for disaster preparedness and coastal flooding have earned Norfolk a reputation for leadership and forward thinking, the city is also addressing other chronic issues, such as poverty. Presently, 16.5% of families in Norfolk live in poverty. Other persistent challenges include high rates of out-of-wedlock births and single female heads of household. All of them are indicators of poverty, and all are causes of poverty, and a major cause of lower rates of educational attainment. And as I mentioned in last week's State of the City address, for too long we've played defense on poverty issues, trying simply to mitigate the worst effect. And so now it's time to go on the offensive and to recognize the untapped potential of our people as both the right thing to do and a critical economic opportunity for us. The Mayor's Commission on Poverty is taking this issue head on. Commissioners are studying available data, reviewing the strengths and weaknesses of current approaches, exploring promising models, and generating a first draft of strategies to improve our poverty statistics. Research has shown that poor and vulnerable residents suffer disparate impacts from natural and other disasters. Chronic conditions, disability limitations, and the need for assistance with activities of daily living are characteristics of elderly and medically fragile populations. For these groups, additional factors such as income, transportation, and social and family networks further hinder ability to prepare as well as to recover. Due to variation in the vulnerability among population segments, a severe storm event or other disaster can be expected over time to have a greater public health impact upon traditionally underserved and medically fragile populations. Researchers at Old Dominion University have found that the disparity in the prevalence of chronic health conditions increases over time following the event, and that the growth in health disparities may be slowed by regional resiliency intervention policies. The desired impact of Norfolk's resilience strategy would include a heightened awareness of the acute shocks and chronic stresses our community faces, plus improved tactics that are linked, trained, and exercised that are inclusive of our most vulnerable populations. The city's strategy should plan for nearly every contingency. It would be fully capable of not just surviving, but thriving in the face of challenges. A successful resilience plan would target not only investments to save lives and protect property and avoid catastrophic economic losses, but would also slow the growth in economic and health disparities among population segments. We can and must do better. A thriving port since the 1600s, home to the North American headquarters of NATO, with sister cities in Japan and Germany, the United Kingdom, France, Russia, Canada, the Philippines, India, China, and Ghana, Norfolk hopes to continue fruitful global conversations through this new global network. Modern society is fast-changing and complex. Political climates, as well as the natural environment, are volatile, with the potential for shocks and stresses. We hope to understand from network colleagues the complex systems we live in and how to make smart interventions accordingly. And likewise, Norfolk has much to contribute to network members. Norfolk has developed an effective process for tying defense assets into our disaster recovery planning and implementation that is transferable to other communities. Norfolk has long been a leader among cities in planning and innovation, and it is with this experience we will build on as we develop our resilience strategy that will enable us to create resilient infrastructure and a resilient economy that supports a resilient community. And so it is with great